Martin Weiser.
Martin Weiser
hat Kulturwissenschaften
studied culture sciences and management.
Mit Behinderung
und works with people with
seinen, so wie er sich ausdrückt, Lieblingsgräuel
disablements and wants to work against advertisements. Dr. Eric Flick works with FIF. It's a forum for computer scientists
und ist ebenfalls terminal genervt von der
and is terminally annoyed by neon advertisements.
Euer Talk, eure Bühne, genießt es.
Your talk, your stage. Enjoy.
Hi.
Hi.
Unser Vortrag besteht aus fünf Teilen.
So our talk will consist of five parts. First, I will describe the problems we see with advertisements. Then I will describe how in Hamburg there was a real escalation. I will talk about our initiative, the law we want to introduce, and how you can take action yourself. So first of all, not all advertisement is equally bad. We are talking about something like we can see here. It's in the way. It's intrusive. Sorry, there was sound missing. So who doesn't know a city like Hamburg from everyday life might not realize how annoying and distracting this can be. These installments are really bright and they are moving and they are really distracting. They exist in analog form as well as digital and are equally as annoying. So the first time you see it, it might be interesting. But because it's stupid content and repeating so much, it changes you. I know that other people feel the same. Not all of them. Some seem not to mind as much. But yeah, the problems are real. The question, why do I have to see this? Is obvious, but never answered. And again, the sound is missing for me, I'm sorry. So, nobody's asking us. It's intrusive and we are forced to participate. It affects adults and also children. There is advertisements for tobacco, even in front of hospitals, because there is no alternative apparently. If it's not working, you could just leave it out, don't do it. If it works, the question is, should it be there? So some advertisement can be ignored easily, but there is the scientifically proven exposure effect that even something that weakly works still works on the long run. So is it a good deal for the city? There's always somebody who says the city cannot ignore the money. But nothing is for free. So what is being sold? The data? Probably not in this time, even though it would be possible with cameras and Bluetooth tracking in the advertisement installations. So right now, what is being sold is right access to your thoughts. Over 15 years, it was $500 million. So this mindshare brings the citizens 20 bucks per year per person. So is this really so much money that we cannot ignore it? We are paying for this with our attention. So apparently it was already always there and we can't. But we have to have it. And it pays for toilets. But there isn't that many toilets. I can't find it. So what we need seems to be important, but is being ignored. And we have that black and white. About the public-private partnership, it sounds convenient, but the government becomes the customer. And not a paying customer, but the they become dependent.
einer unfreiwilligen Aufmerksamkeitsbewirtschaftung. Das wird
so our attention is being marketed, is being sold, but we don't have a say in it. And we are basically just the resources being mined. And the question, why do we have to accept this? Is the answers are not satisfying. Advertisement has always been there. Well, has it? But the publicity is not just really important. And there is no dialogue. What is about people who don't want to be consumers at the moment? And it's a very one-sided monologue. You have to know that it's not local advertisement. It's not really good for the local economy. It's just for monopolists and those who want to become monopolists. It's not good for consumers, because good sources for information is independent and objective, and advertisement can't do that. It's unnecessary, and if we remove those installations, we don't lose anything, quite the opposite. The only thing is workplaces. In theory, it's a valid argument, but if every business is being equal and is being protected, we cannot remove such a thing as coal energy either. It is distracting and changes and distracts you when you partake in the in traffic, and that's on purpose because it's placed where it will catch your attention. There is a lot of light emissions, and that's a problem. And a lot of screens are even placed in shops and windows. That changes the day-night rhythm of humans and animals, and even switching it off after midnight doesn't help much. Even after a year, we don't really have much data about this. In the beginning, this apparently didn't matter much. Even about traffic didn't really concern many people, but we will keep asking. There are 4,000 of these installations in Hamburg. Between 2000 and 2020, around 4,000 of these installations, including background illumination and changing content, were installed.
There has been advertisement forever, but it escalated like this in the last two decades, the early 2000s. See it here at bus stations. 2007, Dröhr put out another offer and holds now a large monopole, and almost never anything got built back. In the year 2000, these adverts didn't exist, so you can see it's not that needed. So, do you need these 4,000? Is it a lot or not? So let's see this. Like, you can see here where these things show up. Every blue dot is a external advertising tool. And most of them are backlit. Some of them are just posters, but like these are also kind of big, and if it's on a house wall, it's even bigger. A lot of them are at crossings. So at the most important roads, you just see advertisement all the time. This is open data. This is from a repo with Jupyter notebooks, where you can look at this data yourself. We also looked at how much advertisement you are pressured to consume. You think that it's less outside. Disappointed. Wanted how much you have to see if you drive through the city, can't really escape. So you pass like 50 of these things if you drive from the inside to the outside of the city.
Die gestrichelte Linie. Das sind durchaus normale Wege, die viele Menschen jeden Tag auf sich nehmen müssen.
Like real normal ways that a lot of people need to take. It's even a bit crazier with bicycles, probably because like the fast roads are rear of adverts for a good reason.
So if
you use public transport, you are not better off. So finance senator of Hamburg said, oh, we won't be have that much adverts in the next few years. Was very wrong, and you can see that in any city that will subscribe to these offers. So I'm giving over to Martin.
Die Initiative Hamburg Werbefrei
ist Initiative Hamburg Ad Free came from a
sehr kleine Gruppe von
Leuten wanting to remove external advertisement. We're a small group democracy, climate, safety stuff, and we hate adverts outdoors, and we think it's a bigger problem. Part of the commercialization of all the places of life by large corporations.
Architektur, Stadtplanung.
And
wir haben uns überlegt, wie wir als
afflicting a lot of areas of cities, city planning. Talked about how we could have a large impact.
Direkte Demokratie als Tool zu benutzen, etwas gegen Außenwerbung.
Started using the initiative Hamburg Ad Free as a tool of direct democracy.
Dazu sage ich später mehr. Vorher möchte ich noch ein paar
internationale. I'll tell you more about that. Here's some international examples how international organizations can do something against advertisement.
In Sao Paulo,
Sao Paulo in 2007, by the mayor,
übergroße Ladenfrontbeschriftungen verboten hat.
A law banned adverts from large adverts from the city. And you can see here before after
this. Auf den sehr große,
ausgesprochen the internet, you can find images of high rises with extremely sexist adverts on it. And most people were very happy about the changes.
Grenoble
was similar, initiative by the local government, by the mayor, and adverts in the public space were removed. This is really big. You can see stuff like this in Hamburg as well. This is a mega light. The stuff below is a city light. On the right, both have vanished. And there's a tree now. In Geneva, you heard about it. This is a new development, which started in
2017.
There was like a mistake in the contracts where multiple hundred advert places weren't filled for a few months. So people put on art and slogans and stuff. People loved that. And we thought, why do corporations like Coca-Cola or whatever get these spaces? Because like adverts are not a natural law or something. So, but they did a new contract. The places were stuffed with commercial adverts again. So an initiative got together and the sign-up campaign. After that, for like 3 years, they lawmakers looked if that initiative was legal, and in this year, in September, the Court of Law in the Switzerland said that yes, this initiative is legal. The Parliament of Geneva had to take on the initiative, and there won't be more.
Allerdings sind die Städte heute überhaupt nicht werbefrei.
The cities are not ad-free at all nowadays. São Paulo and Grenoble still have public-private partnerships at the bus stations. This the same advertising mush as anywhere in Geneva. This will only be legal in a few years. And won't be only be true for places in public spaces.
So
for people to see the adverts, doesn't really matter if it's public or private property, but legally there's a large difference. I'll talk about the Ad-Free Cities Network now. This is in the UK. They publish readers on topics like what's wrong with advertisement, like mental health, sexism, local economy. There's seven local groups. They use petitions, art actions, lobbying to reduce advertising. And just banning some product groups like fossil fuels or SUVs, stuff like that. In France, since 1992, there's a group named fighting against malicious advertisement, not only because for advertisement, but like post stations, TVs, advertisement. There are 15 groups with a lot of actions against digital outdoor adverts.
And to compile just a little information of what we already said, to summarize, there is resistance against the commercialization of the public realm. It's both top-down and bottom-up, but it's complicated. There's not just one law that has to be changed and everything will be good. We have to distinguish, is it public space or is it private space? And of course, there is this unfathomable public-private partnerships. So, let's talk about Berlin Ad-Free now. It started in July 2018. Well, it collected signatures, and it was more than 42,000. So the Senate took 1.5 years to check the laws and decided, nope, we have to keep those laws, even though the Constitutional Court of Berlin decided otherwise. So now they can keep working, and they are collecting signatures again. So this slide shows the situation of Berlin Ad-Free and Hamburg Ad-Free and the concept how to also bring in other cities. So we are depending on the political situation in the following years. In Hamburg, We will start next year with collecting signatures. We don't need that many. If you want to join, please sign. And then we have 6 months.
Wir gehen davon aus, dass wir es schaffen, 10.000 Unterschriften zu sammeln.
And we need 10.000 signatures. I would say we will manage. We are also prepared for the Senate to ignore our proposition, and we are probably have to go to Constitutional Court. And then there will be a public poll. And everything goes well for the next EU election. We will have a law prepared, and we'll have prepared everything for a referendum, and you will be able to say yes to it in the election. So you can feel free to contact us. So people from Berlin, Hamburg and other cities already created this association for the ad-free, to make public spaces ad-free. So our proposition for the law is now about 7 pages, and we want to change the building laws as well. So on the left you would see what is a permanent ad, and we have to distinguish between permanent ads, and on the right side we have a bus with an advertisement. That would not be a permanent ad. So if you sit on the inside, you can't look out. But changing the building laws, we wouldn't affect the bus, obviously. But we try to bring everything together in one initiative.
Nach unserem Gesetzentwurf sind Werbeanlagen auf öffentlichem Grund und vom öffentlichen Grund
so aus sichtbaren ad installations on public ground and visible from public ground should be reduced in 5 aspects. So where it stands, temporary installations, then public transport, and two others. I'm sorry. So, the first one, where it stands, having shop windows and signs of a company is allowed, but having it higher than ground level is not allowed, or bigger than just one floor level. Temporary, then public stops. The format is maximal A0 and smaller. But it should not be illuminated from behind. So it might be illuminated, but not from behind, so it does not pollute everything with its illumination.
Klassische Litfaßsäulen sind weiter zulässig.
So classical advertising pillars are still allowed, but only the ones that are not illuminated. So they are often in the way as well. Single places on public ground. Maximal, they should be 4 meters above ground. Maximum of DIN A4. Not illuminated. Yeah. And now a small quiz. So this is a classical advertisement pillar. It would be on public ground, so it is okay, but the posters are too big, so they would not be allowed. So this is an ad installation. It's too high above ground. It's bigger than 10 square meters, and the posters are a lot bigger than A4. So this I've shown already, it's not allowed, obviously. So this is called a public information installation, and it's really in the way. They are in digital form or just a poster window, but I wouldn't say it's allowed. It's not labeled as allowed, and so it's not allowed. And would also free up a lot of space for people on foot or on the bike. So this, it would be on private ground. Unfortunately, we would not they would not be affected by us. They are on public ground and are not visible from public ground. So, unfortunately, even if we have full success with our law, this would still exist. So we can't reduce all advertisement. And I am really astonished how much advertisement is in the train. You can't just sit there and read a book without seeing some ad moving within view and catching your attention. And I think it's dystopian as well. And just to add to this, there are ads that are connected to news. So who chooses which news are shown? I think that's problematic. So this example, it's an ad installation. You can't see it properly, it's next to a train tracks, so it's public ground, private ground. It's slightly below 10 square meters, so that might be okay, but the poster is bigger than A0. Like this, it would be okay. So a lot of small posters instead of one big one would be okay. So even with our law, there would still be ads, but it wouldn't be as intrusive. So, second to last slide. A lot of these initiatives are successful. This is from the Wikipedia page of the initiative initiatives in Hamburg. 72% were successful to collect the 10,000 signatures in the first level. Many of them, or some of them, were accepted by Senate. Some managed the second stage of collection of signatures and even the referendum. So, for example, the one for the rebuying of the power lines, that was a referendum as well. Then sometimes there's compromises between the Senate and initiatives, like the one for the improvement of bike traffic. Some of the demands were met, others not. So if there might be a compromise with us, that would have to include that there is no more outdoor advertisement in digital form. That's like our main point. So the last slide. We will begin collecting signatures in March. And if you are interested in the topic, please contact us. We are on Facebook, Instagram, Instagram, Twitter, but please follow us on Mastodon or write an email. We are happy about all the help. Please spread the word. You can help by distributing the message and help us make this initiative known to people. I'm done. Thank you. Please imagine ravaging applause here. Thank you very, very much for this great talk. Especially the data that you collected. So it's really difficult how much advertisements there are along the streets. Also comparing. Please sit down.
gerade auch der Vergleich zu den verschiedenen Städten.
So comparing cities between each other was very, very interesting.
Dank euch, dank aus dem Publikum, haben uns
thanks also Fragen from the audience. We have a lot of questions. So do you need more people helping you? Yeah, definitely. The question is easily answered. We definitely need further people. So people are really engaged, but it costs a lot of energy. Also helping or talking to people.
This is needs a lot of time, and we'll need all the support we can get. I hope your servers can be okay with the coming storm. Activists are always welcome. Another question, do you need financial help? Do you have help from the politicians? Well, the Bewegung Stiftung supports us. Thanks for that. Politics, the left in Hamburg. Which is pretty focused on the topic right now. The governing parties don't really. But maybe someone will be interested. The second question? Do you need financial help? That's not really the big problem right now.
Danke für die ehrlichen Antworten.
Thanks for the honest answers. Thank you. Thanks to the Signal Angels. More questions. One question. Are there statistics on how many crashes and accidents happen through these distractions by adverts? That's a very good question. Which we would like to answer, but nobody is asking this in Hamburg, which we know by questioning the government. There are studies from Tel Aviv, where the city speedway had no adverts for a short time, so you could actually show that. There are more studies that don't show that, but it would be interesting to know for Hamburg as well. Yeah, I think the emperor is naked. Pretty often obvious things standing in the way is there so people look at them. So our parliamentary request was written like it's like, does the Senate think that the risk is like zero? If not, why the risk? And this risk gets ignored in advert land and auto land Germany. On the English side of Ad-Free Cities UK, there are some studies, but we'd like to have our own study with our corporation, Public Spaces e.V. So if scientists want to join and do some studies, that would be cool. Now, I'm no lawmaker, but if this happens Yeah, so there's eye-tracking studies where it's actually shown that eye-tracking, that adverts are distracting, so if you are not allowed to look at your smartphone while driving. So I can imagine there's a measurable effect.
immatrikuliert ist und noch ein interessantes
Thema. So, someone is working on a psychology degree. This is an interesting essay or work study you could do.
Im Straßenraum auftaucht. Also, das wäre interessant.
That would be interesting. Thanks.
Habt ihr natürlich mit der Initiative sicherlich
auch now with this initiative,
potenziellen, potenten Gegner.
You might have some enemies. There's another question.
Diesen Gegnern eine gewisse Cleverness nicht absprechen kann. Und die Frage ist, was
tun mögliche what do you do against
also, wie zum Beispiel
people acting around these things, like, for example, cars with adverts on it, parked in front of living quarters, which take away even more space?
Also, ja, diese Fahrzeuge well, gibt es ja in manchen Ländern durchaus auch mit Megafonen auf dem Dach.
These cars even have some megaphones on their roofs in some countries.
Und die Taktik habe ich
tatsächlich. So you have to listen to it as well.
Gauer Vorzeit auch einmal
gesehen. And I saw these tactics in Hamburg some time ago. Which small trucks with advert spaces on the back. Like, is that allowed according to traffic laws?
Zu Ausweichsachen.
Like,
dass, falls Außenwerbung eingeschränkt
bring around the laws.
So mit Arbeitsplätzen wahrscheinlich, dass die Werbebudgets werden wohl nicht kleiner, dann geht das
probably the budget for advertisement probably won't shrink, so more adverts will move onto television, radio and other spaces.
Vorstellen, da steckt ja Geld hinter, dass das gemacht wird.
Like, there's a lot of money there, so that's a possibility. But like, we hope that we can like have an initiative against that as well, which like is not a part of our proposal, but could happen in the future.
Anknüpfen.
Ich möchte anknüpfen und
I want to link to that concept of opt-in. Other concepts of advert have the opt-in.
Telefonspam eigentlich gar nicht mehr erlaubt sind in der EU.
Only like telephone spam isn't even allowed anymore in the EU. So why is this allowed on the streets?
Ist das noch erlaubt?
Like, why is this allowed if you're not even allowed to get spam via post. Mail.
In die Richtung kann man es, glaube ich, auch noch entwickeln.
That's another way we could look at it. Like, streets and cars driving there. Did you hear or not?
Was ihr vielleicht gehört habt,
the beeping noise during the talk. That was our CO2 signal, putting out our first warning, so we have to open our windows, so we get some more O2. That's not show business, that's life.
Explizit von mir jetzt nicht konstruktiv, destruktiv vorgestellte Frage.
Some destructive question.
Rein wissenschaftliches
In the direction of pure scientific interest, what would happen if these screens would subject to microwave energy or stuff like that? And could you answer this scientifically? Yes, they would turn off depending on the strength of the impulse. I don't know, I didn't try.
Don't try this at home.
Try this at home.
Oh, das keiner gehört. Genau. Eine weitere Frage, und ich freue mich über die ganzen Fragen, die ihr stellt, und wir haben tatsächlich noch
some more questions.
Aber ihr könnt noch fragen, das Pad ist noch offen.
Can still ask.
Eine weitere ist,
und one more is,
auch Werbung auf offiziellen
could this initiative ban adverts on public websites of the city? Yes, there are advert trackers on hamburg.de and asked if that would be allowed. The answer was like wishy-washy and they didn't really know.
Die befragten Partner, da sind noch irgendwelche mittels Leute zwischen.
There are some middle people.
Das angeht, habe ich tatsächlich nachvollziehen können. Die konnten das auch nachvollziehen. Guck mal, was für Anfragen rausgekommen auf hamburg.de
geht und alle Cookies. We showed them what stuff it asks for if you go to hamburg.de and what kind of scripts you have to activate.
Wurde schon versucht, die digitalen Anzeigen zu befreien?
Did you try freeing digital adverbs?
Ja, da sind mir einige destruktive
Beispiele. Yeah, we had a few destructive examples for this. So schöne Bilder dann gezeigt. And that wasn't really as nice in the result. So they were hacking a porn site on it, something like that. Please don't do that. But I haven't seen many examples of this.
Es soll ja in Hamburg neuerdings auch eine andere Form von Werbung geben, die auf
bestimmte Apparently, there is other advertisements in Hamburg that shows other situations. Well, should there be other rules for non-commercial advertisements or maybe political advertisements? What's your position on that? After our proposal, political ads are specifically not targeted, so nothing would change about that. Thanks very much.
Das Pad, habt vielen herzlichen Dank für die ganzen Fragen, die hier
in dem Thank you very, very much for all the questions in the Pad. I hope we answered all of them, if nothing else comes in now. And want to thank you very, very much for providing all this information, for creating so for letting us know what happens if nobody does anything. Thank you very, very much for this first talk. I think it was a good start. Thanks for letting us be here. And also